Presentation about Gaggle this year, so I kind of decided I'll do one small presentation anyways. And I'm not going to present any of my own work. This is one of my favorite student projects I supervised when I was a university college lecturer. The history behind the project was that School Linux, which is a distribution for using kind of educational environments, and it's deployed quite widely in Norway, and they got a request from one of the art school teachers in primary school saying, "Oh yeah, I got this new cool thing on the labs and computer. It would be so neat if you had some software to create stop motion animation." And that request got relayed to me, and kind of asking like, "Do you think you would have any students that could do this?" And it's like, it's not that difficult problem. If you say you target user base of primary school children, you can't be too complicated. And it was an extremely nice project, how it ended up. What you need is some kind of camera, a webcam, and the way I'll just actually demonstrate how this thing works. That's probably the easiest. So it's in Debian, it's in, I guess, Ubuntu, Fedora, Gentoo, and many other distributions, and that actually was already there after the 4 or 5 months that the students are working on it. So I managed to actually land their projects in Debian after 4 to 5 months of work. The basic user interface of stop motion looks like this. I actually haven't configured it in any particular way. I need to adjust my camera. It actually managed to detect my webcam out of the box and be up and running. Let's see. Am I in focus now? And I guess people know how animation works. You have a series of still images, and then you swap between them quite quickly, and you get the illusion of motion. So I'm going to try to use the audience here as test subjects, as puppets. So if everyone could lift their arms, or rather, just we have the people like the arm. Okay, people lifting arms. There's a button I can press there. I think it's actually just pressing space. I take a photo. So, okay, some people do that. I'll take another photo. But I thought if people could kind of like do the like waving movements. So we'll start with everyone leaning to that side. Say what I'm doing now. Okay? Keep it, because you're play figures and should be still. So like, okay, this looks good. We snap a photo there. Now move just a little bit up. Okay? Snap there, and a little bit more up, snap there, and a little more up, yeah. And then we go a little to the side, and even more to the side, and even more. Okay, now we'll be taking some photos there. I didn't actually pay attention to my screen, so I didn't see that the audio skinning was turned on. You have different visualization modes for kind of like the few previous frames that have been captured by the system. Or I can do like that and have it. So within the software, I'll just go for a mix and turn down the number of images. Okay. See what's just there. Now I can turn off the camera and we have the animation. I can select individuals of the frames here, which is kind of the history of animated frames that are added there. I can drag and drop frames around. I also have ways of duplicating frames. How was that on? Probably this button. So number 3 selected. No, that's adding images from there. And it's like, I haven't used this in a long time. I just decided I want to show this piece of software to people. The interface itself is designed for primary school children. There's one thing that the teacher probably would have to set up if it didn't work out of the box with the webcam, and that is the actual capture. And there is a list of various things for how you can actually capture images into this piece of software. It can actually fall all the way back down to if you have a program where you can capture a single image with the command line, it's happy to use it. So if you have some way of controlling SLR camera over USB and triggering snapping one image and saving it to a file, well, then you have everything you actually need to be able to do higher than HDTV animations and an interface type to bring things in between it. It also contains the ability to export video, has presets for how it's done, and basically configure the command lines, etc. And that's the part that we guess the primary school children wouldn't do, but the IT administrator would set up how to actually do the video import, at least. The video export allows us to save the animation and perhaps have created by default it allows at least creating all the URL. I'll do one last thing, and that is to show what my students spent the last week of the project on. Is there a way I can get audio here out from the computer? Where is it? Wait. You don't get audio? Perhaps I didn't get the audio, but I'll show the animation anyways. They were playing with Legos for the last week, and there is meant to be some sound effects and audio, but special effects were done because it also has the ability to launch GIMP on the current frame. They just then added some special effects in that way. Well, that's what I kind of had to show. It's like, suppose it's a cool program. It's not for children to actually create animations. You can do clay, Lego, drawings, and backgrounds. And that's it.